Hello and welcome! My name is Sanjin and this is the very first tutorial in Python Fundamentals where we get the handle on the Python interpreter, the variables, and the data types in Python. So our learning intentions for this tutorial are to know what the Python interpreter is, to know what expressions are and how to evaluate one, to know what variables are, how to create one, and to be familiar with the different data types that can be stored in the variable and how this happens inside Python. If that sounded a little technical, not to worry. I promise these things are going to make sense in about 7-8 minutes. So let's start with the Python interpreter. What is it? Well, these three lines that you see right there, they're called a chevron, and they're essentially Python saying, give me some text and numbers, and I will tell you if it makes sense to me. So if it's Python code, or perhaps if it's some mathematics, Python is going to process it and give us an output, or it's going to save information. It's going to do something useful. If it's something that Python does not understand, then we're going to get error messages. So if we say hello, there we go. We started a Python course with an error message. I think that's original. And if we say, who are you? And we're just going to get invalid syntax. So you can't type random stuff in there and expect it to make sense with Python. But what you can do is do some maths. So if we say 1 + 1, there you go. Python knows that that's 2. Now, incidentally, this handles our first two items in the glossary. This is an expression. An expression is a combination of variables, operators, and values. Some of these. What we have here, one is a value, that plus is an operator, and one is a value. And that evaluates to a single value, which is number 2. So, in other sort of arithmetic operations, maybe I can just show you some. So you can say 2 times 5. So the star is the times, and the divided is the sort of dash right there. So as you can see, these are all expressions. They evaluate to a single value. What is next? Well, what is a variable? If I did this, x equals to 5, and then I said x plus 2, most of you would tell me the correct answer right there. That is 7. But what actually happened is fairly important. What we have is this equal sign. That is an assignment of a value to a variable. In other programming languages, this was actually symbolized by an arrow. And if there was an arrow on the keyboard, I guarantee you, we wouldn't be using the equal sign. So you can imagine there's an arrow pointing. We're putting the value of 5 into a space in memory that is x. So x is now storing 5. And there you might have seen in programming x double equals 5. Double equals is more like an equal sign. And this is basically going to tell you if this, if x contains a value 5, it's going to return or evaluate to true or false. So we can do a couple more mathematical operations. We can say x times 6. And we can maybe go 3 times x - 2. By the way, this is BODMAS is in operations here. So if I said, 4 + 5 × 3, this is going to not be 27. It's not going to be 9 × 3. It's going to be 4 + 5 × 3. The 5 × 3 is going to process first. And these are BODMAS rules. So again, to reiterate, all of these are expressions that evaluate to a value. X is a variable, and when you hit X, it's going to say the value of that variable. The double equal sign is much more like the equals in maths. The single equal sign is an assignment. Number 5 is assigned to X. So next we can cover data types. And to do that, you can just do a little thing and you just go type x, right? And x is a class int. So integer in mathematics is just a whole number in programming. Likewise, we are talking about numbers without decimals. But if I said, and this is kind of cool, x equals to x over 3. So you'd notice how this, again, the equation wouldn't make sense. But when you think the new value of x, the x value is all of a sudden going to become a third of what it used to be. So x is going to become 5 over 3. And it's going to be 1.667. So now when I do type x, something else has happened. So it is class float. What is interesting, in other programming languages, you kind of assign the data type that data variable is. But in Python, it changes dynamically. So a floating point is essentially a decimal number, and it has a bunch more memory storage than an integer. So what else can we do? We can have a variable that maybe I can use just... You don't have to use a single letters. You can say name equals to Sanjin. And that is a different data type. So if I go type name, that's called class string. So the data type is a string, and string essentially stands for text. And the way Python recognizes that something is text, it is not whether you type alphanumeric characters, like letters of the alphabet. It's actually if when you pressed equals, what went in had quotation marks. So you can actually do operations with text. You can go name plus name. Sorry. You can do name times 5. I'm pretty sure you can't do name minus name, even though that should work out to 0. You get an error. So operations that you can do with numbers, some of those can be repeated with strings. So we have right now looked at 3 data types. We have int or integers, which are whole numbers. And this was an example when x was assigned a value of 5 and we said type x and it was an integer. Then we divided that by 3 and it became a floating point. Then we played around with creating a name, which was some letters in quotation marks, myself, and that was type string. And as you can see, some of the operations you can do with numbers, you can also do with strings. So that is all recapped. I believe that we've covered these very well. If you have any questions, please go ahead and ask in the tutorials. The glossary is also going to be repeated in the previous lecture, as well as there's going to be a PDF file of the entire glossary used in this course. See you in the next tutorial.
The tutorial is part of a series called Python Fundamentals. Check out the links below for the YouTube playlist and Udemy online course.